So why do I like shooting film? Because it's more rewarding. I mean, it's as cliched as it sounds, it's because of the process. It's far more rewarding, in my opinion, than shooting digital. With digital, you can shoot as many frames as you like. If you shoot 100 frames, you're probably gonna like about maybe 5 of them if you shoot digital. Whereas with film, I'd say that my keeper rate is about 80%. Mostly, the reason why I like shooting film as opposed to shooting digital, it's just more fun. It's not necessarily because it makes me a better photographer, it's just more fun. Like from every stage, from, you know, holding a roll of film, loading it into the camera, the sounds involved, you know, holding like a roll of film, opening up a packet of film, whatever it is, it's like opening up a bag of sweets. The thought of everything going wrong, it just makes it a bit more rewarding. There's a bit of jeopardy. There's a bit of jeopardy involved, isn't there? You know, you take the shot, but then you also cross your fingers hoping that you actually get the image. At every step of the process, you know, it requires you to not mess it up. And I think as a result of that, each frame that you make is just far more rewarding, far more satisfying than having the freedom of digital, of just shooting, you know, as many frames as you like. And because of how much harder it is, because you could literally, from the moment you buy the film, you have to store it right, you have to load it correctly into the camera, you have to make sure you get focus, you have to make sure you expose properly, you have to make sure you develop it properly, you have to hope that the lab doesn't mess up the development, you have to hope that they don't mess up the scan, you have to make sure that you edit it properly. All those little stages, if you manage to get through all those obstacles and you come away with a really great image, it's just far more rewarding than taking a digital camera, taking a few digital frames, getting the SD card out. It's just not the same. It's a completely different ball game. There comes a point where if you develop your own stuff, if you scan your own stuff, it can be, I hate to say it, but it does, it is kind of meditative, it's quite therapeutic, because you have to be on the ball, you have to concentrate on not messing up the process, and that sense of jeopardy where, you know, literally anything could go wrong, and then for it to not go wrong and everything goes right, and that photo that you took a few weeks ago, a few months ago, came out better than expected, it's far more satisfying than seeing your photo immediately. It's not to say that I haven't always enjoyed film. In the beginning, when it was novel, when I picked up my first A1, it was a joy. But then when I realized that I had to learn exposure, I had to bear the cost of scanning and film and developing all that, it turned me off film for quite a while. And it wasn't until I got a bit better at photography than that I could really appreciate and really enjoy film. Because once I learned how to not mess up film, that's when I really started enjoying it and really learned how to get the most out of it. It's a more tedious process over digital, but because of that tediousness, it's just, that's what makes it fun. Mixing chemicals, the sounds involved, that little clicky, that advanced, all those little things you just don't get with digital. And then on top of that, of course, there's like the community. You know, you get to meet cool people. It's just like a really fun, nerdy thing. It is, isn't it? It's just fun to nerd about different film stocks, you know, vintage gear. It's just that feeling of going back in time. And as a result of that, the reason why we put ourselves through this masochistic endeavor is that we form a far closer bond to the image. You know, a far greater sense of ownership and connection with the image. I think that's obviously another reason why it's far more rewarding. Thank you.